Hello, Bea here, and welcome back to Biology. Have you ever watched the track and field events during the Olympics? If so, you may remember seeing the 100-meter sprint. Usain Bolt, the Jamaican sprinter, holds the record for the fastest 100-meter race at 9.58 seconds. This is approximately 28 miles per hour. You might be asking yourself, what does this have to do with the nervous system? As we learned in a previous lesson, the nervous system works by transmitting electrical impulses throughout the body. These electrical signals travel at a rate of 100 meters in a single second. That's over 8 times faster than Usain Bolt's record sprint. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to identify and understand the structure and function of the nervous system. Describe the different parts of the nervous system. Develop an understanding of how the nervous system transmits nerve impulses throughout the body. The nervous system is a complex network of nerve cells, also called neurons. Neurons are specialized cells that transmit electrical and chemical signals throughout the body. Your body has approximately 100 billion neurons. If you were to line all of the neurons in your body up end to end, it would be 600 miles long. That is the distance from New York City to Dayton, Ohio. The nervous system's role in the body is to respond to stimuli, maintain homeostasis in the body, and control the body's mental and physical activities. Neurons, or the cells that make up the nervous system, are specialized and have a unique structure. These cells form bundles that become tissues, or nerves. There are 5 main structures that make up a neuron. Neurons have a cell body, an axon, myelin sheaths, dendrites, and synaptic knobs at the end of the axon terminals. These structures allow an electrical impulse to transmit throughout the body. The cell body is the large part of the cell and functions like any other cell, containing organelles and the nucleus. The cell body is surrounded with dendrites, or branches from the cell body that receive impulses from other cells and sends them into the cell body. The axon is a long, thin fiber that carries impulses away from the cell body. One way to remember this is that both axon and away start with the letter A. Myelin sheaths are an insulator that are made of fat and wrap around the axon to protect it. They act similar to the rubber coating on an electrical wire. This insulation helps impulses to travel faster. At the end of the axon are the axon terminals and synaptic knobs, which send the electrical message on to the next cell across the synapse, which is the small space between nerve cells. The nervous system has 2 main parts, the central nervous system and the peripheral nervous system. The central nervous system is made of the brain and the spinal cord. Its main job is to control the flow of information from the brain and out to the body, then back again. The peripheral nervous system is made of the nerves that radiate out from the spinal cord to the rest of the body. Let's spend a little time looking at the 2 main structures of the central nervous system, the spinal cord and the brain. The spinal cord is a column of nervous tissue that runs from the brain and down through the vertebral column. This column of nervous tissue is very fragile, so it is protected by cerebrospinal fluid, soft tissue layers, and the vertebrae of the spine. The brain is a more complex organ. We could spend hours going into all of the details of the anatomy of the brain, but for the sake of conciseness, we will focus on five main areas of the brain. The cerebrum is the largest part of the brain. It interprets and controls responses to sensory information. It also contains the areas of the brain for intellect, memory, consciousness, and language. The cerebellum is a walnut-shaped area of the brain at the base of the cerebrum. This is where the body's conscious and unconscious movements originate. The thalamus is located at the base of the brain and acts as a central hub where messages must flow through both on the way into the brain and out of the brain. The medulla oblongata. That's fun to say, right? The medulla oblongata is part of the brain stem and controls involuntary responses like heart rate, breathing, and coughing. Finally, the hypothalamus is the part of the brain that regulates the body's internal environment and keeps the body in homeostasis. Think about what the perimeter of a shape is. It is the distance around the shape. The prefix peri means around, which is why peripheral is the right adjective to use when describing the peripheral nervous system. Where the central nervous system is in the center of the body, the peripheral nervous system contains the nerve tissues that spread out from the spinal cord in the center of the body and into the trunk and limbs. The peripheral nervous system is made of two subdivisions, the somatic and autonomic systems. The somatic system controls the motor neurons. It connects to the skeletal muscles in the head, trunk, and limbs, and is under voluntary control. It is also responsible for your reflexes. Remember when your doctor taps just below your kneecap and your lower leg jerks up? That's your somatic nervous system at work. The autonomic nervous system is just like its name implies. It is automatic, or involuntary control. This part of your nervous system works to maintain homeostasis by stimulating or inhibiting glands to secrete hormones, your heart rate, and your smooth muscles. The autonomic nervous system is controlled by the hypothalamus and the medulla oblongata. After spending this lesson learning about the structure and function of the nervous system, it is probably clear that a fully functioning nervous system is vital to a healthy life. Unfortunately, there are numerous disorders that can affect the functionality of the nervous system. Multiple sclerosis, or MS, is an autoimmune disease that causes a loss of myelin sheath, which can cause debilitating pain and a loss of control of your muscles and movements. Autoimmune diseases are caused by your body mistaking your healthy tissues for foreign tissues and attacking them. While multiple sclerosis is an autoimmune disorder that scientists believe is caused by a combination of genetics and environmental factors, other disorders of the nervous system can be caused by injury and trauma. An example of this could be a concussion, which affects the brain, or a spinal cord trauma. In a spinal cord trauma, the neural tissues of the spinal cord are compressed, pulled, or sheared, affecting the motor neuron functions of the peripheral nervous system. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how the nervous system, a complex system of organs and neurons working together, is able to coordinate and regulate the body's functions. In our next lesson, we will be looking at the circulatory and respiratory systems. Until next time, remember that biology isn't just science, it's the way of life. See you next time!